know Tomkins had a back room on the second floor. Her name was on a neat brass plate on one side of the door. And how many ladies, which in brighter circumstances worsen, she was independent, or by going out and nursing. Companion she had but the one, a beautiful tomcat, who was a famous mouser and a devil for a rat. His colour was a tabby, his skin as smooth as silk. She would lap him every day as he lapped up his milk. The widow Tomkins kept herself aloof from every neighbour, her pleasures all consisting of assisting at the labour. One night she was awoken with a double rat-tat-tat. She left in such a hurry, she quite forgot the cat. Tom, as soon as daylight came, walked up and down the floor. He heard the dog's meat woman crying, "Cat's meat!" at the door. And when he heard that well-known cry to meow, he did begin, for he could not get out and she could not get in. Confined to just a single room, he could not roam the house. He wanted a companion, if it only was a mouse. He watched a hole in vain, no mouse came, his hopes a crown. Either he was too much up, or the mouse was too much down. With hunger he grew fairly wild, the formerly so tame. Another day passed slowly by, another just the same. With hunger he so hungry was, it did so strong a sail, that all of very loath he was obliged to eat his tail. And though the stump was sore, the next day he was tempted, sad, to eat a little more. To make his life the longer, then he made his body shorter, till one after the other, God, he ate his hind a quarter. Now hunger is a spur which has such long and pointed rounds, it spurred him on next day and next to gobble all his bowels. He walked around on 2-4 legs, alas without beholder, till more and more by hunger press, he dined on both his shoulders. Next day he found the cannibal to eating more a check. Although he tried and did reach all he could reach of his neck, he could not bite his ears, and oh how mournfully he cried. Towards the door he turned his eyes, cocked up his nose and died. Last return, and oh how she did stare. She guessed the tale as soon as she saw Tom's head lying there, and with grief sincerely heartfelt, she found his fate a hard one, and she buried him beneath the apple tree just down the garden. Now mark, my friends, how aberrations in this world appear. The fruit of that sad tree was changed, and strangely too next year. The neighbours say, and 'tis truth, for their folks who goes to chapels, this Catshead was the first true cause of all the Catshead apples.
Thank you. apple. It's not for apple. It's not. Very much to be done, okay. Catty.